Well, tomorrow is St. Patrick's Day, and many people around Maryland are already celebrating.
Yeah, but they'd better keep a lid on it, because police will be setting up extra DUI patrols to discourage drinking and driving. 11 News reporter Rob Roblin is live in Fells Point tonight with more. Hi, Rob.
Well, here at Fells Point tomorrow on St. Paddy's Day, this place will be hopping. And for the police, they will be out in force looking for drunk drivers. St. Patrick's Day is a time for celebration and for many people having a few drinks. But that having a few drinks part, if you get behind the wheel, is a bad idea.
For the 5 days before St. Patrick's Day in 2010, troopers made an average of 16 DUI arrests a day. For St. Patrick's Day and the 4 days after that last year, they made an average of 38 DUI arrests per day. That's a lot of drinking and driving and drunk drivers that are on the highway endangering the safety of others.
In an effort to keep those numbers down, people celebrating are encouraged to use the Tipsy Taxi program on St. Patrick's Day.
What the program does, it offers free cab rides home to revelers that have been celebrating in a Baltimore City bar or restaurant on St. Patrick's Day from 4 p.m. to 4 a.m.
Today, representatives from AAA Mid-Atlantic visited bars and taverns in Fells Point to encourage owners to have their patrons tomorrow use Tipsy Taxi.
It's a valuable part of our industry, I think. It's a really nice gift that they've given to us to be able to take care of people that, you know, might have one too many. I mean, this is once-in-a-lifetime opportunity that everybody should take advantage of.
So if you celebrate St. Patrick's Day tomorrow, don't drive if you've been drinking.
We love the Irish and everybody who pretends to be Irish on St. Patrick's Day, but just don't drink and drive.
And as you can see, they even have these little bracelets you can wear, the Tipsy Taxi, and it has the phone number on it, 1-877-963-TAXI, and they say it glows at night. Reporting live, Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.